Hello students, in this session we are going to discuss about accounting for share capital issue of shares, part 1. In this chapter, let us take a sample question so that we can understand it better. Let us evaluate Chota Bhim Limited invited 10,000 applications of rupees 10 each, payable rupees 3 during application, rupees 4 during allotment, and remaining rupees 3 during first and final call. Suppose the company has a good reputation and 20,000 applications have been received. Due to the excess application, the company cannot allot everyone. So, the company has decided to send the letters of regret, that is rejection, for this shares. The basic entries that should be passed right now is bank account debited, 20,000 into the application money 3, that is 60,000. And it should be transferred to share application account, being share application money received. Now, since this is an excess application, this has to be transferred share application to its original place. That is to share capital account. And if there is any excess remaining, it shall be transferred to share allotment account. And the letters of regret that we have sent, it shall be transferred to the bank account. So this 60,000 which we have, it should be debited, and remaining share capital account. Since the company has issued only 10,000 shares of rupees 3, 30,000 shall be sent to share capital account, 5,000 that we have rejected into 3, 15,000 to be sent to the bank, and the remaining 5,000 that is extra. So the right now the shares which are available in the business is only 15,000. So 15,000 into 3, it moves to 15,000 to share allotment, being share capital share application money adjusted. Now, the students have to analyze the question and underline this part, whichever it is going to be. Example, Raju is shareholder holding, that is allotted, 400 shares. Didn't pay allotment money. Now the calculation will slightly differ. For this case, we have to just divide this into two parts. One part, it is for the company that we are going to analyze, and then another is for the shareholder that we are going to discuss. Remember, if you follow this steps, you can solve any type of a question. Let us find out step number one, calculation of total allotment money received. Under this, we have to find total applied. So that total applied 10,000 into 4, we have to receive 40,000 rupees. Under this, we have received some excess application that we have shown in the previous entry, 15,000. Right now, the company has to receive 25,000. Under this, there is a shareholder, Raju, who hasn't paid the money. So, we have to find out Raju's money and then we have to evaluate. To do Raju's calculation, we have to follow again three steps. Step number one, since holding is given, holding is nothing but allotted, then we have to find calculation of applied shares, step number one. This is again the most confusing part for most of the students. If we want to find applied, find out the total applied. Remember our part, 10,000 shares, 15,000 is remaining. So now we want to find applied. So total applied are 15,000 divided by 10,000 into number of applied allotted 400. It gives you around 600 shares. So Raju has applied for 600 shares. Step number two, calculation of excess money paid by Raju. Under this, 600 shares that Raju had applied into 3 rupees, it comes around 1800 paid. Now Raju was allotted only 400 shares due to the excess application, and then 1200 is the money transferred to share capital, 600 is the excess application money. And the last step that you need to do is calculation of allotment due by Raju. Now, last, total allotted shares by Raju is 400 shares into 4 rupees is our installment. So it comes around 1600, out of which excess paid by Raju during application. This 600 we have to deduct, then remaining is only 1000 not paid by Raju. So this 1000 we have to transfer here. 1000, then 24,000 is the money received. Allotment money received. Let me just evaluate a part of question in this. Suppose another shareholder, Chutki. Paid first and final call money along with allotment. Now this situation will put you in calls in advance situation. So Chutki's shares, let us take 300 shares. Along with this money that we have received, add Chutki's excess money, Chutki's first and final call money. So it will be 300 shares holding into 3 rupees is the first and final call. So total money that we have received is 24,900 during the time of allotment. Let us pass the journal entry for this case now. Share allotment account debited, transfer to its original place in advance, taking that it's a due, 10,000 into 4, 40,000, 40,000, being share allotment money due. Now, since we have received the money, we will pass one by one. Bank account debited. Total money that the business has received is 24,900, out of which calls in arrears account debited 1,002. Share allotment account is 25,002. Calls in advance account 900, being share allotment money received. So the students, we will see you in part 2 where the cancellation of shares and reissue of forfeited shares will continue. Thank you.